Hello, calculator fanciers. A bit of a unusual one today. People have been sending in calculators for me to unbox, which is very sweet of them. I think some people have calculators they think should be unboxed by a professional, and it's very considerate of them to send them in. So I'm going to go for the record of most calculators unboxed in a video, sight unseen. So let's get into it. First up, this one we've been sent in here at the South Surrey and Associated Regions Calculator Appreciation Society. For professionals and amateurs, and no indication where or who has sent this in. So let's, I mean, this is more of a calculator I'm bagging so far, but I'm going to allow it. Well padded, so it doesn't get damaged. It's come with a note. Please find enclosed three calculators, which I hope you will unbox. I haven't got time for that, and frankly, three is cheating. So I'm only gonna unbox one of these. We're either going to do the scientific calculator with cover, we're going to do the home and office scientific calculator, or we will do the Wilco scientific calculator. Make sure you get your sums right. Vote now. Yep, it's the Wilco. So let's get into that one. Let's pop this thing open using scissors for when you're doing speed unboxing. I mean, you know I like my specialist tools, but sometimes you just need a multi-tool for everything. And we are in. Okay, in no time for instructions in a speed unboxing. Is that a cover? Yeah, okay, it is. Oh, it's got a little stand. That's nice. And let's fire it up. So we'll do a simple test to, oh, wrong way around. It's a root 2 equals times root 2 equals 2. It works. Okay, you can see how someone saw the calculator and thought this will be a good one to unbox, but this, what a drab little, there's very little going on here in this particular calculator, and so I don't think it warrants any further tests. I'm impressed that someone had the enthusiasm to send it in, but I mean, it's no Gaxio is what I'm trying to say here, so we'll pop that in the not particularly exciting pile and move on to whatever this one is. Okay, and we have, oh, this is exciting. It comes in a smaller unmarked box. Wow, what could it be? I mean, I'm not fluent in all barcodes, so that I mean, if you are fluent in barcodes, spoiler alert, that's already given away what's gonna happen, but I don't know, so let's, okay, and let's, okay, all right, ooh. Oh my goodness, already, okay, it's not a rectangle, so I'm already more excited than, what the, it's a keyboard! Okay, well hang on, let's test it first before we get too excited. How does it even turn, how does it turn on?
Solar powered.
Is it solar powered? Needs more, not enough light? Okay, we're okay, and it's on, all right, so if we give it enough charge, I feel like we should do like the harmonic series. What are we gonna do? 5 times 6, okay, it works. Okay, so it does straightforward stuff. Where's clear? On? Okay, on doubles is clear. That's not very useful. Off is off. On is on. And it doesn't play any sounds. So if it played music as I was typing, I'd be impressed. But sadly, it doesn't. So there you are. Keyboard calculator. Up next, helpfully labeled, this is the box. That's very useful. I think I've done enough unboxings to recognize a box when I see one. So let's get, oh, they've used electrical tape, which is a nice touch. Obviously in professional circumstances, I wouldn't just be hacking at it with scissors and ripping it open, but given we're just doing, you know, a fun little unboxing of ones that amateurs have sent in with a letter. Dear Numberphile, I'm happy to present you the staff device, a device that looks and behaves just like a normal digital clock, but if you hold down its middle button while turning it on, suddenly it becomes a calculator. Let's get in there. Oh my goodness. Oh wow, this looks dangerous. It comes in bits. How on earth did this not get flagged up by the post? This would not look good on an x-ray. So, okay, and that's all that, we've got all the pieces. That seems to be the main body of it. This is a dangerously homemade looking power supply. Wow, I mean, it must be legitimate. They've written it on in Tippex and a European socket. If only there was something in the name of my organization which starts South Surrey and Associated Regions, which would indicate I'm doing this in England and I'm unable to plug that in because we have Queen's voltage over here. A and so I can't plug that into it. This European socket won't work. I believe we had a vote on this recently. So I'm going to file this away for further investigation. Up next, okay, this one's come via Amazon. Let's get into there. Okay, that was a very straightforward. This is almost a trivial unboxing. It's just open. Oh, okay. No, there's more. Still not fully worthy of an unboxing yet. And we have, oh, Texas Instruments. Oh, okay. Someone has sent us in a Texas Instruments because people get very upset that in America, all their calculators come from Texas, and we don't tend to have many over here in South Surrey and associated regions. So someone has finally cracked and sent me in a TI, the TI-30X 2S. That's an unnecessary level of versions it's been through without a correct name. So let's turn it on. And oh, it already comes with a calculation preloaded. So it's already got 2 asterisks to the power of asterisks times tan of something. That's to help people if you're using it and you're not familiar with doing calculations, as an example one. Or maybe in the factory, that's just that's a Texan testing it. Or actually, if you rotate it, it's like a little smiley face. I appreciate all the feedback everyone gives, however misguided it may be. And I know everyone wants us to do more Texas Instruments, so we will do, we've heard you, you voted with your calculators, we will do a Texas calculator special. So I will get a whole bunch, we'll have a look at some. Don't worry, we will get around to Texas Instruments. Thank you for sending it in. Okay, and this one, I mean, unboxing it is trivial. We can already see it. This was actually, it wasn't posted, which is why it's already open. This one, someone came and gave it to me at the Manchester Science Festival. So they came up and said, here is a calculator pen. So let's get in there to have a closer look at it. And there you are, no surprises from what we saw on the outside. It's exactly what we, oh, look at the instructions. That has to be a new record for the compact and efficient placement of instructions. And look at that, no unnecessary information. Look, they didn't even use both sides. They're like, that's all we need. Why print double-sided when you can just fold it in half afterwards and cram it in there? And they've got a UK patent on, they figured, you know, someone else is going to try and beat them to market for the crossover pen calculator market. It says auto power off, and it's very efficient. The moment I turn it on, it's off again. So is there no battery in there? I mean, if only there was some other way to use this without, oh, there's not, there's a pen, right? So obviously I can, so the pen doesn't work. The pen is also auto off. What is this? We should better get in there to, wow, so it's got ink in there. Maybe it's just been, okay, so it was a fan who came up and gave this to me, but I'm starting to question how much they really liked me. So, I mean, look at that. This is clear, this is an aged product. I don't know how this went so long and people were able to resist opening it to get out the calculator pen. This is clearly a product of a legal loophole somewhere, where it's like, you're not allowed a calculator, but you can bring in a pen. Or you have to do all your mathematical working out by pen. And they've gone, not a problem. I will do all my working out by pen, right? So there you are. I mean, full points for creativity. But sadly, I'm going to have to take it into the shop and get it looked at properly because this is a vintage model and it's going to need a proper refurbishment and a going over before it's in a state for me to unbox and review it. Here we go, we're almost at the world record. So next one up, another anonymous little sack. Let's get into this. Oh my goodness, second mystery box. And so again, if you know your barcodes, there might be a spoiler there. Oh my goodness, it's transparent. Look at that. Okay, that's kind of cool. Okay, it's a guard, everyone. It's okay, I can remove that safely. And there's no way that's gonna work. There's no way. How does it know what I'm pressing? Clear. It worked! Oh my goodness. Often, my desk is just dense with working out and notes about calculators and all sorts of maths. And you go, well, where am I gonna put my calculator? I wanna cover up some of my maths. Now, you can put it down and you're barely losing any of the maths you had available before. So that, I can see that's quite handy. And I guess, as a professional unboxer, if I've got another calculator I want to unbox and I want to do some calculations at the same time, see that I can unbox two at once. Like, I'm barely obscuring the one behind it. Okay, this one has already been opened because it wasn't labeled as a calculator on the outside, and so I opened it thinking it was normal post. And oh my goodness, and this is it. It was the Casio DataCal 100. And oh, this is intriguing. You can schedule a telephone call to tell someone a secret. I mean, that feels like a particularly niche, narrow thing, but should this situation ever occur, you can do some calculations at the same time, because this is a new generation of calculators. So the box is already open, but it is still here. I mean, it's missing a little tab there, which is a bit sad, but it's got what on earth? Operation manual. I haven't got time for that in a speed unboxing. Is that a note? Oh, okay. It's the receipt from the original purchase. Okay, that's quite nice. So someone has bought this calculator in December 8. So the 14th of December, a year that ends in 8. I mean, I'm going to guess there's the tab. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, so there's that missing tab from the end there. So this has been purchased, I assume, in 1988. I could be wrong. This is why you should always use the full, the complete time code. Very disappointing they've not used that. Someone's paid £17.75 back in the day from this, from John Lewis. And that's actually, I mean, I know a lot of people try hard when they want to be a serious calculator collector and they send them in. I try and be encouraging. And I always say, keep all your documentation. If you can't show the provenance of the calculator, what is the point of having it in your collection? And someone here has actually kept the original sales receipt from a branch of the John Lewis Partnership. So well done, someone out there. You're halfway to being a serious calculator appreciator. I mean, I'm a little confused, partly because this is a very unusual device and partly because I appear to have woken up in the year 2041, which, I mean, time flies when you're unboxing calculators, but that is ridiculous. This is here because in some calculators, if you press up, up, down, down, left, right, A, B, you know, you can unlock special modes. Do the square root test. Times 2 square root equals nothing. What? Times? Oh, I didn't times properly before. 2. Really gotta push these buttons. Wow. Equals. Oh, it's rounded down to, that's not good. So I'm gonna put that in my curiosity pile. Thank you, whoever sent that in. And I will have a closer look at what on earth is going on there. And maybe I can tease out its secrets. Who knows? And I'll keep the original tab. Can go in there with the receipt. That is a pretty complete collection. I'm impressed. And finally, in our attempt, the 8th calculator, because you always do powers of 2 and, 16. I mean, no human could unbox 16 calculators. Oh, ha ha. Oh, so some comedian out there. I mean, I don't really go in for jokes and comedy, but someone thinks they're hysterical and they've sent me in an abacus. I almost think I shouldn't even give it the decency of an unboxing, but I am a professional and I refuse to let down my standards. Okay, so this, it sticks. The clear entry function isn't working properly. Some of the previous entry is still in there. Anyway, that's a hard reset. And what is this? That is a manufacturing default. The display is, that's like a dead pixel on the display of this abacus. Nope, 2 dead pixels. Okay, so I guess we can try and do a calculation with this. Let's enter into, there's 7? And I'm going to divide it to a 7th, and then multiply by 7 again. So there you are, an abacus, well done. Someone out there thinks they're hilarious. And I guess, I mean, it's quite a funny joke, sending in an abacus. I can appreciate that someone out there is a comedian. But a calculator unboxing video is no time for joking around. So it's not appropriate. But thank you to everyone who did send in proper, serious calculators. It's been fun doing a speed unboxing. We'll be back with some proper, serious unboxing soon.
Numbers should be equal to the mean.
Tricky.
What age group is this aimed at?
Well, clearly from the front, children and amusement.
Hang on here. It says suitable only for Nobel Prize winners.
So that's... so you got one.
They're putting these all back in order.
So, yeah.
300's there.
So there's going to be another one.
400's.